Sam and Ging, may your marriage teach you all you need to know about love. May it open up for you the meaning of your life and help you distill wisdom from the many experiences you'll share. Today begins a new chapter in your unfolding story. May your journey together bring you much happiness and joy. There's a reading called Blessing for a Marriage, which you've selected. The writer says, may your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitement marriage should bring, and may life grant you also patience, tolerance, and understanding. May you always need one another, not so much to fill your emptiness as to help you know your fullness. May you want one another, but not out of lack. May you entice one another, but not compel one another. May you embrace one another, but not out encircle one another. May you succeed in all important ways with one another and not fail in the little graces. May you look for things to praise, often say, I love you, and take no notice of small faults. If you have quarrels that push you apart, may you both hope to have the good sense to take the first step back. May you enter into the mystery, which is the awareness of one another's presence, no more physical than spiritual, warm and near when you are side by side, warm and near when you are in separate rooms or even distant cities. May you have happiness, and may you find it making one another happy. May you have love, and may you find it loving one another. As you begin your married life, remember to let the love you have for each other find expression in some way every day. When all is said and done, it's not how famous we are, or how much money we have, or how successful we may be that will give us the satisfaction and happiness we seek. The true measure of our joy will be how much love we have in our lives and how well we've learned to give it away. Samuel, now that love has brought you to this moment, do you willingly commit yourself to Ging and, before these witnesses, declare your intention to be her husband, to share your life openly with her, to speak the truth to her in love, to respect her and encourage her own fulfillment through whatever life may bring? If so, say, I do.
I do.
And Ging, do you willingly commit yourself to Samuel and, before these witnesses, declare your intention to be his wife, to share your life openly with him, to speak the truth to him in love, to respect him and encourage his own fulfillment through whatever life may bring? If so, say, I do.
I do.
And to all of you, give your blessing to this marriage. If so, make some happy sound. Unites two families and it creates a new one. And as witnesses of this union, Each of you is invited to play a special role. You've heard their promises, and some of you have made similar ones yourselves. So you know that saying these words is one thing, and then living them out day by day is something else. I don't think any of us really makes it alone in life. We all need the love and support of our friends and our families. So having witnessed these vows, I'd like to invite each of you to also make a vow. Will you, their family and friends, do all in your power to support their marriage in the years ahead? And will you promise to pray for and encourage them that they may fulfill the vows they've made today? If so, say, we will.
We will.
Thank you.
This ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
And Ging, as you place this ring on Sam's hand.
Sam, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
Ging, by the promises you've made and with the blessing of God in this gathering, I'm happy to pronounce you husband and wife. Sam, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Samuel Quinto.
There's to complain about.